Hello, internet friends. My name is Beanie Bay, and this is more Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, but I'm bad, a light commentary playthrough where I play through this entire game, much like other playthroughs I've done before, like all the Dark Souls and Bloodborne and Final Fantasy XVI and VII Remake and Integrate, the Intermission DLC, and then both God of War, and then both Jedi games. But this one's a little different. I'm not going to talk a whole lot, or at least as much. Whole like commentary thing, because this game has lots of talking already, lots of awesome cutscenes. I decided to change the look, went out for dinner and birthday stuff. I am actually stuffed. The stuff is me. Hi, I'm stuffed. And I wanted to play more Rebirth because it's my birthday, so we're gonna play more Rebirth. Let's get some lore. Yeah, kick that lore. Hell yeah. And the velocity of Choco Jet is pretty wild. Any more Odin lore? Same poison cap from the mountain? Guess so, yeah.
This ends here.
Let's keep it up.
I had to change up Cloud's sword though. I was tired of looking at the purple one. It looks great, but I've had it on for, I don't know, 20 hours of game. Or more. Had to make a change. I don't know if I can come back up here. This is Odin Sanctuary 2. I guess Sanctuary 1 is right here. No. Look at this man. So he has Zentetsuken, and what's the spear? Did Final Fantasy VII Odin have two weapons? What's the spear, though? I don't need this every time.
Analysis complete. I managed to extract the necessary data from the crystal. This should allow me to strengthen.
It's unnecessary. Honestly, you could just go like bim boom bim. I mean, he could just talk for a moment, but.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Well, yeah, and those little things when he's talking to you on the Chadley device have like old Star Fox 64 lip flaps. They're just like dual barrel roll. You know, they don't actually. Yeah, again, it's a little bit. Honestly, I wonder if Square will hear the feedback and like patch it out. Probably not, but. I'm stuck. That was weird.
See you around.
That was a whole thing. I hope the voice actor isn't getting paid by the line. Also, considering that line of dialogue was only recorded once. And voice actors normally paid either by the hour or by the page. Depending on your what your contract is. Like when I was looking into getting a voice actor for projects in the past. It was normally how many pages is the script. Like the overall script, and then the script in pertains to how much is actually their lines.
That'll do.
So you got an 80-page script. But the character you're in question has, you know, dialogue equivalent to 25 of it or something, you know?
Try this.
Get him!
Ready?
Apparently not.
Here goes. You'll see. That'll do. Sorry, but I gotta. You okay? One more shot! Lend me your strength. And catch! That's it! One more shot! Okay. Just a bit. Bring it, you've got this.
My turn.
Hey.
Gotcha. You're done.
With how much they reuse it, we should ask for more. Right. These markings. Excuse me, Barrett. Bruh.
Thank you.
Dangerous fiends may be in the vicinity. Exercise caution. Rare Valron variant detected. Commencing guidance protocol. It is thought that the ominous coloring of this variant is meant to intimidate its enemies. This corresponds with its aggressive nature. Once it finds prey, it attacks in a frenzy. As an aside, Valrons were sighted in this area only after the Mako reactor was constructed. Because of its humanoid form, there were rumors at the time that these creatures were actually humans who had undergone a horrific transformation due to Mako exposure. Setting aside the veracity of these claims, one thing is certain. The advent of the reactor coincided with the Valron's appearance. This could be a good opportunity to delve into the mysteries of their origins.
It looks crazy.
Gathering combat to law on target.
Too bad.
Moonstones.
Deal with that.
All set. Go on. Now that's the spirit. Just warming up. Not throwing in the towel.
Very large dragon. Human thing. For main story or a side quest, okay. Getting the trajectory right on all these gonna be.
Hmm.
Didn't really turn very well. Is this the right one? Okay, do I have to? What side of the island do I have to? This doesn't connect. All this looks like side quest locations. Okay, that's a boss fight room up there, and there's one up there, and over here. Oh, I see. Do I have to wait to target their jaw specifically?
There, come on. Five. I could do that again.
You probably have to be channeling when you use an ability to target it. Wee.
do that. Let's get this over now.
Now!
I'm here!
Good time.
Let me out! Moving on then.
It's like a mountaintop war bunker. Look at all the ammo crates. Yeah, we're going. I'm right next to it. Splash.
Cloud, by analyzing the Lifespring data, I was able to locate an old Republic transmitter chip. It should be on a nearby island. Once they discovered Mako in the area, Shinra established an offshore outpost. Oh, but they've long since vacated the isle, so I doubt you'll run afoul of their forces.
That's where I was. I think. Yep.
Let's see if we can't find that chip.
If this is what you want, that's it!
Nothing to it.
Planet Spirit now. Expeditionary Medal. Or Expeditionary Medal. Increases limit level by 1 at the start of battle. Oh no. Really? Oh, a King Zoo Feather? That's our hunt. So it just raises it by one, but doesn't give you it. Kind of like the remake of the Gotterdammrung. Enhanced Resplendent. Enhanced Yggdrasil. Varvatos. Varvados. A lot of things. Although I can't make those. The Yggdrasil is going hard though. 2x3 or 3x2 linked. Okay, so Varvados and Garm are the next high one, mid another. Oh, Resplendent is just one step below the Yggdrasil. Oh, well, one step below, but well, materia below, but higher stats, higher defense. Work on armor later. I'm sure there'll be a new, might be new purchasables. You know, of all the things he used adaptive triggers on, they didn't use adaptive triggers on Choco Jet. Like the more you press it, the more you'd fly, and the less pressure you'd have. Right now, it's just on-off. You have to keep pulsing it like this, which keeps making your camera move. Boy, is it why. So the camera gets a little annoying after a little while. It's cool, but... you have to, like, do this to hover. Whoa.
So, what? We doing this?
Rare Disgorgon variant detected.
Large
commencing
boy.
Guidance protocol. As the Disgorgon evolved, it grew exponentially in size until it could no longer fly. At the same time, however, it began to produce a deadly toxin. This toxin is found in its cheeks and jaw and can be stored in large quantities. It's created from the insects that form a staple of the Disgorgon's diet. The toxin's properties vary from species to species and are dictated by the type of insects consumed. This variant, for instance, is capable of paralyzing its prey, so caution is advised. Nevertheless, we mustn't let such dangers deter us.
So I'm going to attack his jaw.
Wow! What a fight!
With me!
I know you can do this! Yeah.
Hell yeah!
Yeah!
You're up.
Okay!
Too bad.
Wow! Come on, fight!
That's it! Let's go!
Now.
Don't give up.
No holding back.
No, I'm cheering for you!
That was close.
Gotcha!
Shit.
Trying to wait for it to cast the petrifying mist. There we go.
No being can stand against you.
Almost. Needs a little more. Some of the fights have unique requirements, but
Stellar performance, Cloud. I can't thank you enough for providing such valuable combat intel. I'll use this data to further enhance my guidance functionality.
That would be a grave misuse of our resources.
Requesting attitude adjustment.
In any case, I've utilized the data for a new challenge. Feel free to access it via the combat simulator when you have the time.
Phony and Rondo. Some of them did, but I think they're to teach you specific things because some of the, like, don't heal or don't get frogged are, like, unique little things. Most of the time when it says pressure an enemy, that's already a unique thing. Like, to pressure that big guy, we had to attack his jaw only during a certain animation, a certain attack, right? Or some of them, a lot of them are just pressure them using their elemental affinity. Usually those enemies are just tougher to beat. So you just, it's a simpler thing to pressure. Otherwise, when it's an easier enemy to beat, it's like a tougher thing to pressure, I guess. Because pressure leads to stagger, that's normally a thing. But a couple of them, that one in the early area of Junon, when you have to defeat them before they fly, that's just basically hitting them both with an ATB ability when they're singing, which is how they're pressured, which is on their assess enemy intel card. So it's almost the same thing. Yeah, some have been specifically unique. Others are just make sure you pressure the enemy, and to pressure them, you have to do a specific thing. I missed that completely. That sounds like a cat meow sometimes when you hear it. And it really gets schmoovin' if you pulse it. Hello. Just trying to knock out the world stuff on the way to the story. I know we're going to have to come back through and do side quests and stuff here most likely, or I don't know where the campaign's going to take us, but kind of like once you're on like the open world section, you finish the open world and then you do story, or you finish story and then you do open world, you know, whatever works. I would assume our hunt mob's gonna be right there, I'd say. Yeah, probably. The animation of everyone else doing this is so incredibly goofy. So weird. Zantetsuken? Not Zantetsuken? Different pronunciation, like Chadley there? Because I think Final Fantasy 16 pronounced it differently. That's where I had Zantetsuken, not Zantetsuken. Maybe Zantetsuken is more of the Americanization of the word. Because in Japanese, everything is decided even more harshly by the vowels. So, Zantetsuken. Whereas in, I guess, English. Obviously, things are enunciated or broken up by vowels, but I don't think they're usually not as pronounced. You know, the same word, it's just play different pronunciation. Oh, go fast. It's like 50% of this is all just doing weird flying stuff. Oh, hello.
My turn. Let's do this.
Do it.
Come on.
Ready.
Do it.
Okay. Bring it. Get him.
You're dead.
Oh, these are the regular ones. I didn't scan them yet. No.
That wasn't so bad.
Whatever, they're everywhere. There's just four or more on the island over there. Further in. Huh. Bunnies. I got beat up.
Odin Crystal.
I'm doing it backwards. Oh.
Perfect. Thanks to your hard work, I've obtained invaluable.
Yeah, see, that maybe that has to happen for some game state based thing. I don't know. A lot of up and down going on right now. Controller's going nuts. So much rumbling. Goodness. Funny, oh, too far. Inertia, momentum, one of those things. Too slow, okay. Ah! Okay. One square. It's two squares, but my brain. Ah! Chocobo! Don't need this.
I've managed to analyze all Odin will serve. Ah! Though you have yet, you'll first need to.
Yes. Yes, 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 yes. No, we've unlocked both. It is said that beyond the desolate, jagged crags of Mount Nebel lies the land of the dead, and few dare to approach its slopes. Indeed, even plant life struggles to find a foothold here, and with tumbling boulders and rock slides a constant threat, the locals see little reason to make such a perilous journey. Many of the mountain's caves are filled with Mako vapor, and the inner reaches contain Mako springs and naturally formed materia. Shinra's search for a new energy source led them to Mount Nebel, and its abundant supply of Mako made it an ideal site for the world's first reactor. Although it played an instrumental role in the proliferation of Mako energy, the Nebel reactor's time in the spotlight was brief, and it now operates at greatly reduced capacity. In the shadow of the jagged formations at the foot of Mount Nebel, the village of Nibelheim had little to offer the outside world. However, their quiet existence would change dramatically when Shinra's discovery of vast reserves of Mako within the mountain. The company's effort began with the construction of Shinra Manor on a plot of leased land. It was there that the head of research and development, Professor Gast, and his assistant, Professor Hojo, pioneered studies on Mako and Genova. Shinra's financial investment delivered the people of Nibelheim from poverty. Their newfound happiness and prosperity would be short-lived, though, as the entire village was burned to the ground and countless innocents slaughtered by Sephiroth. A perfect reconstruction of Nibelheim is later erected on the site in secret and now serves as a treatment center for victims of Mako poisoning. Oh. Oh, we can see our materia here. We get Comet and Cometeor. Oh, wow. MP absorption. Dark side. Very Odin-themed, or underground-themed. Yeah, increase ability points by 70% and suffer 5% HP damage with each use. Eventually goes to 20% and 5%. Oh, oh baby. There it is. There it is, though.
Thank you.
Oh, and the way up was over there. Maybe? What type of monitor is that?
Nibelheim's not far now.
First time back since.
Yep. First time.
Same here. Didn't seem worth coming back till now. Didn't think there was anything to come back to.
Sorry.
It's all right. Lots happened since then.
Oh, the 32.9 curved ultra wide. Where would you put a second one? Behind your head? Above? Yeah.
Rare Nibelwolf variant detected. Commencing guidance protocol. The wolves of this region maintain a strict hierarchy. The pack leader is said to be imbued with an azure flame, which gives its fur a distinct hue. As the leader, this wolf will often distract prey, allowing for its packmates to sneak up and catch their quarry by surprise. They are highly intelligent, to say the least. In fact, there are countless stories of these wolves turning the tables on would-be poachers. We may never get a better chance to study the ways of this clever creature. So go get that data. But watch out for its friends.
Oh, Lord. Dodge or guard, but then hit it while it's quenched in flame. It's weak to fire, though.
Here.
I believe in you.
There.
Blue fire is ice based. Oh, my bad. I forgot the inner workings of magical blue fire being cold or ice based. Choco trick stuck. Stuck in the pillar.
Cloud, stay close, would you? I honestly thought I was ready for this, but it's just too real.
Trying to turn around is kind of a nightmare. It was right there. Barret?
Good news, Cloud. That lifespring yielded information on a very rare fiend. The King Zoo rules the skies of Neeble, and now we know where it roosts. Seeing as this talent terror has been causing trouble for the Black Robes, I suggest that you clip its wings.
Where are you going, little guy? Please. Cloud's butt needs a butt cushion. Much choco back. You know how things are like biodegradable? These cushions in 7 Rebirth must be like butto-degradable or something. Bio-debuttable? Something like that. I saw you rare materials. What's going on there? Divine Heartwood is the stuff. Seriously, but every time I land, there's always a tree right in front of me. Then the thing I need is right behind the tree. I guess I don't need it. Want is a strong word. This is the last Moogle house, I think, right? Here we go.
Would you mind rounding up all the Mooglets for me?
Muala, you're the worst.
Thank you.
So that turned a little too aggressively. I almost thought I was gonna time out. Oh, come on, really? Moki, come on. No. Billy, right underneath him.
You're giving up, Koopa?
Lower difficulty? Nah. I'm getting Moki first. Sometimes the moment they turn, they just turn and fire. You see? Depth perception. Oh shit! It was off the bottom of the screen.
Already?
Oh, I wanna. Damn it. Normal isn't two hits. It's three. Is that a typo? It was a patch for 7 remake, really? Well, I think after we finish this little bit up, I could
please bring back all restart the and check. For me, Koopa.
Are you serious? Oh, the angle. Really? Don't do it, Mosh. Angles.
You're a lifesaver, Koopo! You're a true hero! Every single Emporium is once again open for business, Koopo! It was Mog and Mag's hope that these special shops would bring happiness to folks all throughout the world, Koopo! And that dream lived on, passed down to their children, and their children's children, and so on. For countless generations. One day, these Mooglets will inherit that legacy, like those before them. Oh, before I forget, I have a super duper amazing present for you to thank you for all your help. You're gonna love it.
Koopo?
Oh no.
Koopo.
Go on now, be good hosts and show our guest how it's done.
I was not ready for this. I'm gonna throw up.
So what did you think?
Not bad. Koopo.
Why did it do the push-in, close-up, sexy cloud lips?
Now that we've been reunited, the Mooglets and I will continue our efforts to spread joy all over the world. Also, we found a bunch of rare and exotic items you won't want to miss out on. Come see for yourself, Koopo!
Oh my god. Koopopo made me close the game.
Anything interesting catch your eye, Koopa?
Then you open it again later, right? Oh, the Moogle's amulet. Oh, will drop items when defeated in battle. So there's the Koopo amulet and the Moogle's amulet. This is probably better. Now, Oh, there's a couple pieces of, there's a couple of crafties that need so many materials though. Probably helps rare items drop over the default ones. Kupopo?
Did you find anything you like, Kupo?
So this is the pre-order one, which is the increased amount of materials collected. Sometimes you have like a 50% chance or something to gain plus one on a material. Maybe it could be less than that. It's really helpful for the rare materials you need like 30 to 50 of per craft. No HP bonus. Probability enemies will drop items when defeated in battle. I wonder if that increases the rare drop chance, though. Maybe we still Kupo Charm it. We're not farming mobs right now. Okay. Well. I feel like I need a break to go throw up or something. Trying to get there without going into Nibelheim proper. I'm waiting to start that on the next chunk so that I can just go in. Don't have to worry about anything else. I think this might be up. Down?
Oh, monsters! Come out, wherever you are!
Rare Cubeldon variant detected. Commencing guidance protocol. Note the distinct shape of its upper jaw. That sharp, many-toothed appendage allows it to skewer prey. The Cubeldon then uses its forelegs to bring the impaled meal to its mouth. These voracious omnivores will eat anything they find, including plants, animals, and even corpses of fiends. Depending on what they've devoured recently, their appearance and physical capabilities may vary. While individuals do not pose much of a threat, they can be extremely dangerous in large groups. Culling these fiends will help keep the nearby village and farmsteads safe from their appetites.
These are called Carnifexes. Games Workshop's gonna be on the phone.
Allow me. Deal with that.
All set.
Good lord.
Camera. able, no doubt thanks to my quality guidance.
Or in spite of your excessive chatter. I need to adjust the speech frequency setting.
No! Stop him, Cloud! He's trying to silence me!
Anyway, thanks to your hard work, Cloud, I was able to devise another combat trial. I'm confident this one will pose quite a challenge.
I mean, Mai doesn't talk anywhere near as much as you, Chadley. Oh, so we can get everything but... Looks like there'll be more when we move into town. Alright, let's go fight a big bird. Mm-hmm. I probably should sit, right? Yeah. Little butto-degradable cushion. Fought Bahamut. Tell me, King Zeus scarier than the God of Destruction? Hey, maybe. Yes. Destroy its wings during swan song, or obviously hit it after its swan songs. Lightning.
No holding back.
Yeah, it's kind of spicy. I don't think we can actually hit it yet. Oh, okay. It comes down.
Don't overdo it.
Here goes. I keep my distance if I were you. It's your turn. Oh, let's go. And catch. You watch me? Great. You're fine. Bring it.
A lot of damage, though.
Come on. There. Come on. Let's do it. Ready?
Damn, radius on that's nuts. A lot of damage, but not that bad. The double fire tornado wall thing is pretty rough.
Excellent work dethroning the King Zoo. Attempting to prey upon you proved his undoing, and without that winged terror flying around, the skies are clear once more. Those robed folks must be breathing a collective sigh of relief.
Well, all right then. I've been watching live, hoping you're enjoying it. Sorry the forehead is covered up right now. But after going out to dinner with my folks, I was so stuffed. I came back and I was like, I am in total chill mode, but I want to play more Rebirth. If you've been watching on YouTube though, in the higher quality YouTube cuts, thank you as well. But I will see you all in the next one. Don't forget there's a ton of other series if you want to watch stuff. All of Final Fantasy 16, all of 7 Remake before this, a lot of 14. Got Bloodborne, all 3 Dark Souls, Demon Souls, both God of Wars, whole bunch of stuff. I think that's all we can do in unlocking the zone, so we head into town.